Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's highlight a really special ether, the THP ether. A THP ether is a tetrahydropyranyl ether. A simple example is shown in the upper right of the slide. Here is the THP group. Like benzyl ethers, the THP ether is interesting because of its particular reactivity. Before talking about reactivity, let's see how to make a THP ether. THP ethers are made by reacting an alcohol with an alkene called dihydropyran in the presence of a small amount of a strong acid. People often use tosic acid, THOH. The full structure of tosic acid is in the upper left corner of the slide. Tosic acid is a solid, so it's easy to put just a few crystals of the acid into the reaction. Under acidic conditions, you know the first step of the reaction will be to protonate something. We are going to protonate the alkene. Alkenes are protonated to give the more stable carbocation. In the case of dihydropyran, we'll protonate the carbon away from the oxygen. That gives this carbocation, which is stabilized by resonance. I'll drop those hydrogens. Although fairly stable, this is still an electron-poor carbocation. It's a strong electrophile and reacts with our alcohol, a weak nucleophile. We've now made our CO bond. We can finish the reaction. We'll use TsO minus to deprotonate and make our, it's a little messed up, but to make our THP ether. So we've made a THP ether through attacking a carbocation with an alcohol. Like any ether, the THP ether can be cleaved with strong acids. The THP ether is, however, even more sensitive to acids than other ethers. Here is a molecule in the bottom left with two ethers, one a THP ether. When treated with acid, H2SO4, and water, we can get protonation of one of our oxygens. To form what really is a leaving group. This whole thing is a leaving group. We don't have a halide to serve as a nucleophile, so to cleave this ether, it will have to cleave through an SN1, which requires a really good carbocation. The ring oxygen, the THP, will help stabilize the carbocation as it pushes out our alcohol. That's our alcohol. And here's our carbocation. We've now broken our CO bond. The ether has been cleaved. Here's our alcohol. What's left of the THP might not look like a carbocation, but we could draw some resonance and show that it is. In water, this carbocation will ultimately form this alcohol side product. Through this cleavage reaction, the other ether remains intact, this OCH3 group in the bottom left of the molecule. We saw with the benzyl group, it can be very handy to be able to have multiple examples of the same functional group in a molecule and only have one of them react. Now, if you are especially observant, you might have noticed that a THP ether is different because the central carbon has two bonds to a more electronegative atom. This carbon has a different oxidation state. So in the upper right, we're talking about that carbon right there. It has two CO bonds. This carbon is formally considered an acetal carbon. We'll learn more about acetals in a later playlist. That's the THP ether. It's very useful because we can break it under very mild acidic conditions.